Let's now go across to my colleague Chaitanya, who has been tracking all the details on this story. Chaitanya, the latest we are getting to know is that the CCTV footage that has now come out, which the police has recovered, two cameras outside Gauri Lankesh's residence, have given an exact account of how the incident rolled out last night. What are you hearing from the police?
Well, at the spot where I'm standing right now, it is exactly at the gate of the house of Gauri Lankesh. And this was the spot where she parked her car and then she went inside the gate. This was the gate she opened. She went inside, and at that point of time, there were two people who were following her on a bike. Both of them were wearing a helmet. The pylon rider got down and then he pulled out a pistol, is what has been told according to the CCTV. He pulled out a pistol and then he fired the first bullet that was on the back of Gauri Lankesh. And when she turned, he fired two more rounds which were on the chest. And when she was trying to run towards the door, when she was trying to run towards the door of her house, there was one more round which was fired, and that is when it hit her head and she collapsed at the spot. So total four bullets were fired is what is being told to us according to the version of the police. But then you can also see, in fact, that is the CCTV camera which is installed over there in the corner exactly besides the door, and that is the main CCTV camera which has caught a lot of footage or the exact incident as it happened from the gate till the time she collapsed over there. And after that incident happened, both of them escaped from this particular route of, towards this side of the house. So these are the details that we are getting from the police. However, the police has kept this CCTV confidential, and they are still trying to find out, because now over here you see that the accused, in fact the suspects, were wearing helmets. So it is very difficult to find out the identity of these suspects. Now if they were on a, if the vehicle number was also not clear, so even these are some of the details that the police will try and find out. And also there will be a lot of the footage, in fact, will also go through a lot of forensic tests as to if they can find out the number of the vehicle, or if they can get a small idea as to who was wearing the helmet, any signs in fact which can help them find out as to who was wearing the helmet and who were behind this particular attack. And that will be quite helpful. As of now, it is also understood that in a statement which was given to the police.
Absolutely. That is exactly what I was going to touch upon. You also gave us information that the statement that has been given to the police by the family confirms that Gauri Lankesh had told her family that two men were following her on Sunday while she was coming back from office.
Well, that is the statement which was given by her family members to the police yesterday night. And the statement itself says that yes, Gauri Lankesh had told her family members that two people had followed her from Gandhi Bazaar, where her office of Lankesh Patrike is located. So they did follow her from that office till her house, but then on that day they did not try to attack her. Well, why did not that happen, and what was the reason, that again is a part of investigation. But then yes, Gauri Lankesh did get a hint as to there was someone who was following her, and she mentioned about this incident to her family members, and the same has now been recorded in the police statement by her family members. Now this is also something which is very, very crucial over here, because this was not the first attempt, we can say over here. There was another attempt, but then that failed. So this is something which has come to light today after her family members have spoken to the police.
Chaitanya, stay with us. We have more reactions coming in from Gauri Lankesh's brother and sister. Let's first cut across to that.
I'm not getting the right words to speak now. I'm just requesting the government to catch the culprits immediately and take action as soon as possible. Because it's my sister. As she was a reporter, she was a editor, she was a journalist, she was an activist, and apart from all that, she was a lady, she was a woman. So I request the government, please investigate as soon as possible and catch the murderers. That's all I can say.
No, we are demanding the government. Home Minister came here, we demanded him. See, 2 years, Kalburgi's death. Enough. Enough is enough. Now, काम शुरू करो, कामयाब बनो.
But will it actually
start, do the work and you should
last time around
it.
Also people said that.
But yes, but one thing I will tell you, this kind of fight, no, in 1 day, 2 days, it is not possible. Mm-hmm. We fight. Maybe hundreds of like us may die. Tomorrow somebody, day after tomorrow somebody, next year somebody. But what I want to tell you are all media persons. Mm-hmm. Gauri was a journalist. Never hesitate to tell the truth. So whoever tell the truth, mind you, follow her. Sir jhuka ke kabhi nahi kaam karne ka.
So we are living in an era of intolerance. This is what you're saying.
Yes, that is not just Kalburgi, Pansare, Dabolkar or Gauri, Iklak, Junaid, hai na? And whatever is happening in our coastal area, every day, in the name of Gaurakshan, this, that, everything. And in the name of taking care of my respect as a woman, they are ready to kill somebody.
Always a staunch Hindutva critic, is it?